It was a surprise to my mom. It's like, Dad wanted you to have his scalp. When I got the first place award, and I looked up in the sky and I said, Dad, you should be proud of your vehicle now.
Hey guys, make sure to subscribe to our channel. You know, international scouts are near and dear to my heart. This one is one of my favorite stories. Enjoy.
I have a 73 International Scout 2. It is the original color, Glacier Blue. Paint job's 3 years old. The rest of the vehicle's pretty much stock original.
And just tell me, how did you get this truck?
This was Dad's vehicle. He bought it when it was a year old. Been in the family, well, he passed away in 2000. I inherited it, and it started to see a little fading in the paint because it kept outdoors, and I decided, you know, I'm going to make it look better. So my son and I, Labor Day weekend 3 years ago, sanded it down, painted it, and it's what you see today.
And you grew up in this vehicle, I'm sure.
Oh, yes, I did. Dad's hunting vehicle. This thing, him and the dog would hop in it if none of his kids went with him. And I can remember this thing, actually, when I come back from Nam. This was my dad's vehicle. And we went hunting together. You know, obviously I got married. He towed his travel trailer behind it. A lot of fun stories hunting. Mom and Dad would go on family reunions with it. You know, just all over the place, and very reliable vehicle.
And what was that moment like where he gave you the keys and said, this is yours?
Well, he didn't really give me the keys. My mom did, and it was a surprise to my mom. It's like, Dad wanted you to have his Scout because he felt that I was the most worthy, the one that would take the most care of it and keep it in the family. My son that helped me painted it, I told my son, it's like, make sure you do a good job on this because one of these days it might be yours.
I do
very much. You know, it's like 3 years ago I brought it up here for my first time, the 10th annual, and I told the audience when I got the first place award, it how special it was, a little bit of history behind it, and I looked up in the sky and I said, Dad, you should be proud of your vehicle now. I get thumbs up with it almost everywhere I go, get a lot of attention, you know, and it's like, man, if they'd make those like that again.
And I mean, the story with this truck is so special. It's just, this is like, you know, what these vehicles are about. It's not just the sheet metal, it's the heart behind it.
Oh, exactly. And every one of these vehicles at the show actually had a story behind them. You know, these vehicles, they were built when there was no corrosion or outer body rust through protection, you know, and this has been a Nevada vehicle all of its life, delivered in Gardnerville, 45 miles south of where I live. And you know, Nevada is a pretty dry climate, so they stay pretty good, and you got to take care of them. You know, it's just a love. I love to keep them going. I love to keep the history going. You know, I was the only International Scout 2 that I saw this year in hot August nights. Saw a bunch of Broncos, but I think I had the only Scout 2.
Mm-hmm. And just tell us really quick about, you know, what does it mean to support veterans?
I'm a member of Vietnam Veterans Chapter 989 in Reno, Nevada, member of the Color Guard. In fact, this vehicle and the trailer is going to be in the Nevada Day Parade the end of this month. It was decorated earlier yesterday with all of the military magnets, all of the armed forces recognized. And, you know, people just come by and give thumbs up and thank you for your service, you know. We as Vietnam veterans never really got a welcome home. You know, when we come back, you know, everybody staggered back at different times, you know, and now the veterans are actually being recognized, and it's really a plus to see that. It is the stock original 345. It is the large engine for the year. In fact, on the quarter window on the driver's side is what they call a line setting ticket. This vehicle has every option that you could get for 1973. Makes it really special. Not only to attract attention, and what's nice is they come with a remote control to where you could actually, you know, change it. Obviously, when you're driving, they got to be white facing front, you know, so it's solid, which gives, you know, kind of LED, you know, like a headlights on. And it, you know, it just another attention getter. And it's like, you know, This one guy, when I was pulling up in to line up for staging for a parade, I had him in slow motion with the fade going, and they changed from blue to green to red. And the guy was looking at him, and he goes, "Wait a minute, those headlights are changing color." It's like, I know I'm not drunk. They were one color a minute ago, now they're different. So it really caught him off guard.
All right, Ray, thank you so much for sharing your special story with us. And that's all I have, cruisers. I'll see you on the next one.